This is part two. I pretended to be in love with Al for 3 whole years. I repeatedly told Al that I dreamed of being his wife. In return, Al treated me like a real wife and took excellent care of me and my sons. At the end of 2008, having known Al for 3 years, I begged him to marry me. My oldest son had gone back to Mexico, and I insisted that I needed to visit him there, and for that I would need legal papers. Al, being the good man that he is, agreed, but not without a prenuptial agreement. I was upset about the prenuptial agreement because it would mean that I would not have any rights to any of his assets, but my main goal was to get the green card for myself and my sons. At the end of August 2008, we got married. I immediately started to provoke him. He said he wasn't happy being married to me, but he promised he would not file for divorce, at least not yet. I had to move quickly. I threatened him and told him that if he wouldn't file a petition for a green card for me and for my sons, I would have him arrested. He made me promise that I would not involve the authorities and filed the green card petitions for me and my sons. I knew that our conditional green cards were on the way. I waited until we were married for exactly 3 months, and I took my sons and got to the police station. I filed the first complaint against Al. The police drove me back to Al's house. A couple of days later, Al filed for divorce. I was served with the divorce papers by the sheriff. I immediately contacted a lawyer. The lawyer explained to me that my only and best option was to falsely accuse Al of domestic violence. I began looking for a VAWA-funded domestic violence shelter. The first couple of shelters I contacted refused to accept me because there had been no physical violence between Al and me. I finally got in touch with the VAWA service center, the International Women's House, P.O. Box 1327, Decatur, Georgia 30031, phone number 770-413-5557, email iwh@bellsouth.net. I was then coached by their employee, Laura Mora. She told me exactly what I needed to do. I went back to Al's house. Then, when Al tried to talk to me, I told my son to call the police, which he did. When the police came to the house, I told my son to tell the policeman that Al had called me stupid. The policeman wrote it down in the report, but he also said that if I called again, he would arrest me. Next, I got a hold of the police report and showed it to Laura Mora of the VAWA shelter. She said it was all the proof she needed and admitted me to the shelter. On December 19th, 2008, I moved to the shelter driving Al's SUV. On December 31st, 2008, my sons and I visited my sister and my brother-in-law for New Year's Eve. Sometime later, Al arrived to get his SUV back. Al brought a bottle of wine with him, which he put on the table and said, "Happy New Year." I immediately started to provoking him again, hoping to instigate a violent scene, but Al simply left the house. Al got into his SUV using a spare key and drove it away. I was left without a vehicle, which made me really upset. After discussing my situation with Laura Mora of the VAWA shelter and others at the shelter, with the help of a pro bono attorney at the shelter, I filed a petition for a temporary protective order against Al, falsely accusing him of domestic violence, rape, and attempted murder, and requesting Al's SUV. I got the ex parte signed by the judge, but I still didn't get the SUV. At the court hearing, the judge knew I was lying and dismissed my petition. I had to return the SUV keys to Al. Even though the judge determined that my accusations were all lies, it didn't make any difference. The shelter helped me get a professional certification, employment, cash assistance for relocation to the West Coast, where we are now receiving many social benefits, including free housing and college education, and an express immigration process to obtain a green card and U.S. citizenship, all paid for by the U.S. taxpayer. Thank you all for reading this. Please write down your comments below.
Ella no era así, y a través del tiempo las palabras se las lleva el viento.